And sorry, my video is not on. Today, Domingo Becquet is going to give his personal success story and tracker. Yesterday, I called him and I said, let's have a success tracker person. And he volunteered. And the reason he volunteers is because he's excited. He's very excited about the opportunity, even though it was, 2.5 years ago, 3 years ago?
Yeah.
And with that opportunity, he became number one unit supervisor in the entire nation, the year before. And this year, for sure, he will be number one as well again. So I'm excited that he has the opportunity to talk to you. And please look at it as, okay, there are so many very successful people in our team. What do they do to be successful? What are the steps that they take? And hang on every word he says, hang on every direction he talks about, and that will definitely make you successful. So from time to time, Domingo, I might interrupt and ask a question or thing. Sure. But other than that, we are delighted, we are happy and excited that you're on Zoom. And if there are any managers or mentors that are on Zoom and your agent or agents are not, please contact them. While you're listening, send them a text. All right. Go ahead, please.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Caribbean. I love it. Thanks for the nice introduction. So good afternoon, everyone. And I don't know, good morning in Hawaii, right? So today I'm going to share my, success story working with Bankers Life. And this is something that I really, really would like to share, even on the first time that I've been with the company, because I found it very effective. So what I want you guys to do is kind of like really take some notes, because most of my agents that I work with, I share this, and all of them, if they follow, they make a lot of money, they become better, and they love what they see, and they become successful as well. Okay, I'd like to show you this picture. And this picture is actually, I can't really have, I used to have a picture when I was a little, but I cannot find it anymore. Way back when I was a fourth grader, I started to think that, you know, I want to see a big houses. So every Friday, I brought my bicycle, went and drive it to the place wherein there is big houses in the Philippines. And I dream, I am a dreamer. I said to myself, one day I would like to have this kind of this big house. And guess what? My teacher always spanked me. You know how in the Philippines they spank me, because I cut class. Every 2 o'clock on Friday, I left the school and went to this place. I don't know why, but I'm so passionate. And that is what happened to me. Every time I see something, it actually manifests. So my name is Domingo Becquet. For those who doesn't know me, I am the USM in Los Angeles. I started with Bankers last December 2019, which is like, no, that's not 1 year. But this is an old one, but it's almost 3 years now. I became a Speed SNA last February 28, 2020, and became Speed RPA March 29, 2020. I'm also a member of 3090 Club, 10,000 Club member, promoted to FTA in same year, April 2020. But from FTA, I jumped right away to become a USB in June 16, 2020. This is one of our best milestone, when I recruited 100 agents in September 2020, the same year. Then I was promoted as a USM in February 1, 2022, and won all the contests except for the printer. I tell you, every single contest I won it when I was a regular agent. I am also a convention qualifier at Miami, Florida 2020, Bahamas in 2021, and now Los Cabos in 2022. I never miss the convention. And I'll explain to you why. Okay. So this is my story. My family background, like I said, in every man's success is the secret weapon behind him. And this is my secret weapon. Meet my secretary, my best friend, my inspiration, and my love of my life. That's Lenny Kisson. She is my wife, and she supports me in every single way that I do. My three Ds, which is my big why. I have three boys. I call it three Ds because their name is based on Domingo. So Donald, Dominic, and Douglas. My eldest is a Donald graduate of architecture in Berkeley, California. My two other sons, unfortunately, they're both diagnosed with autism. The sad thing about it is my eldest is very smart. He got all the brain, and the other two got diagnosed with autism. So he is advanced. Now, I grew up in a multi-level marketing industry. See what I did? This is my second family. I grew my family to six now. I have three boys and I have three kids with Lenny, with her kids. So we combined together as a total of six. So that's how I did it. And we have a big family now. So my family foundation, right? I grew in a very poor environment where education is the second priority because it costs money for my parents. But values are very high. Small town where the only source of income was only working from the rice field, fishermen, or growing foods. I observed and witnessed most of my relatives die without taking the risk of elevating their lifestyle. After my dad passed away, I was 3 years old. We were sold to our uncles and relatives to survive. At age seven, I was exposed to work. I don't know if you guys understand and can relate because I know there's a lot of Filipinos here. I start working, you know, where when they pick mangoes, I was the one catching it fall from the basket. So I got hit so many times with mango in my head, it got knocked down, really. And I got paid 7 cents per mango. So I have to really work, hold, and really move fast to get that mango because at least it won't get break. It won't be broken, so when we sell it. So that's my first job. On my education, I'm a graduate of business of science and business administration major in accounting and marketing. It took me 7 years. Why 7 years? Why? Because I am a working student. I learned and worked my way up to learn more business value by exposing myself to different mentors in my career. 7 years, why? Because I only took 3, 6, 9 units. So it took me 7 years to graduate one simple 4-year course because I have no choice. Because restaurant was the most flexible schedule to accommodate my school class schedule, I got molded and grew in this industry. Stayed and mastered the ins and outs of the food industry. I worked in a restaurant, became a regional manager, and the latest one is Pollo Loco, for how many, 27 years. Because of what I learned from this industry. Here is my best practices, guys. No matter how good or educated you are, if you don't plan, if you don't have plan, it could lead to failure. It's like I said, if you fail to plan, you're planning to fail. So I want you to take a look at this, how I molded myself to grow a particular company because it helps a lot. You can't reach your goal if you don't know where to start. A goal without a plan is just a wish, right? Am I right? Without a plan is just a wish. Right now, we're back in action. We have the plan, and we're going to do it because the moment I start not doing it, my people will not follow. So as a leader, we would like to make sure that goal is always in place. This is the first thing that I did when I first came in as an agent. Establishing where to start, I put my vision board. My vision board looks like this when I first came in. This is the original one that I have. Yes, the picture is kind of like crooked. Sorry about that. But let me tell you, it helps me so much because every single day I put this whiteboard in the bathroom, in the door, and in the sala, everywhere I go, because I wanted to know if I am hitting my target. I put there the compensation plan guide, my target income, how many recruits. That's why we did what 100 recruits in like less than 6 months. I put there my long-term goal, short-term, and plan of action to achieve it. And of course, the milestone. Every time there's a milestone, speed SNA, speed RPA, PA, 10,000 club, I always make sure I put it there and check it. Remember the printer that I did not get? That's the one. I hate it, but that's the only thing I did not receive when I was an agent. So talk about compensation plan. I mastered it. I just want to make sure that when I present it to my future recruit, I understand the ins and outs. The ins and outs, meaning even whatever money they can get every contest, I explain to them. And guess what? We have a program right now in my team, or I can share to everyone, that you can make up to 150 to 190,000 in 3 months. You just have to follow that game plan. Otherwise, it's not going to work. We did it last year with one of my agents. She just missed it because of the timing, but she made 123,000. So guess what? If you guys were going to follow it, it's really, really effective. Just like I said, we showed that all those 100% matching. And we also have this quarterly bonus that I invite my PRP and show them this is the only company that gives you 75,000 3 days after the cutoff date of your quarter. And they will ask how. And that's how I start putting everything into action. So how much income per month or quarter? I would like to share with you this. How many PRPs per month per quarter? How many appointments per day? How many sales per week per month? I did that for the whole year in 2020 during pandemic. I never stopped making sure that this is being followed, right? So I would like to share with you, this is our team target for 2023. I think it's better for you to know this, because once you don't have it in place, it's not gonna work. So my team APC for the first quarter target is 100,000. Maybe Domingo is smoking, right? No. Why? Because we have the plan in place. We have people who's gonna join us, joining and currently in my team, working hard to get it done. Agents with application of the team per month, PRP. Another thing, people talk to me like when I was first came in, they asked me as a manager already, as a USB, how many PRP are you going to bring? With Mr. Caldivia is like smiling, because everybody's saying 12, 10, and I said 30. And everybody looked at me and said, this guy is really crazy, because they never had that much PRP, right? But Mr. Katibian, being a boastful manager of mine, my dad, he says, watch out, guys, 30 is nothing. We deliver more than 50 just for that particular month. Because I knew, I foresee, I mindset myself that it can be done. This business is a matter of just putting it in your mind that it can be done. Speed SNA will go for 40%. SNA 70%, RPA 70%, PA 30 agents, and FTA bonus. Mark my word, I will do it. 25,000 this quarter. I will do it because of mindset, right? Here is another one that some of my best practices that really helps me and my team. I always tell my team, don't put a cap to yourself. Sky's the limit, guys. Everything in this world is possible. What your mind can conceive, you can achieve. Do you agree or disagree? Tell me for those superstar in this call. Because if you put yourself a cap, you are just limiting yourself. And another thing is you're organized and structured. what I loved about this company, I am kind of structured, but I'm not organized. Kind of structured, but not organized. When I meet Mr. Kadibian, he has everything in terms of structure. I have the training and organization, but I don't have that mindset of like to that detail. He has that. So I said, you know what? Let me work with this guy. Don't reinvent the wheel. Create a system and then duplicate. Do not say, oh, I'm going to do this again. And just follow whatever we have in place and you will not go wrong. Let me just show you what I do. So if you structure your working time, it will help. For example, this is during pandemic. I pretend that I go to work because you cannot go out, right? 8 to 5 is my working time. Nobody can touch. I orient my family members during that time and said, I am on my working or I am on my development time, right? Organize your plan and stick with it. I just got scolded yesterday by Mr. Kadibian and said, you have to stick with your schedule. It just so happened, I'm so excited, I'm bringing PRP left and right again. So I have to talk to this. I said, I think there's a prioritization also, right? We have to prioritize what is productive. Still take 10 or 30 minutes break as needed. And then put everything in writing. Too many distractions will ruin your schedule if you don't. That's why I use my notebook every time, wherever I go, I write everything. Even in the bathroom, I write everything if something pops up, right? Habits of my organized people, write things down, establish routine. Every morning I wake up, drink water, walk. To-do list is needs to be stay current. It's not just because you put it there, you don't do it. So once you have a to-do list, make sure you start, finish it. Even sometimes I finish at 3 a.m. because I don't want to add it the following day. First, clutter on a semi-daily basis. If your office is very disorganized, your mind is disorganized. I have my stapler, my pen on the same place where I put it. There's a label. That's how you kind of like organize it. Have a place for everything, optimistic and goal-oriented. If you put a goal, don't just put it like a goal. No wishful thinking. Make things happen. Don't put things until later. You know, our culture as a Filipino, most of the Filipinos are here, mañana have it, right? Tomorrow we'll do it. Tomorrow we'll do it, right? Okay, block time. That's another thing, guys, block time. If somebody is using your time because you don't block your time, that's also not gonna work. When I was in the restaurant, running a region, 7 restaurants, I told my GM, general manager, from 12 to 1, if I call you, it's just an emergency, but I will not call you. Why? Because that is production time. In our business, block time means you are doing one-on-one with your agent. So if you're doing one-on-one with your agent, hello, tell everybody, hey, this is my development time with one of my agents.
Hello.
So please respect 2 hours will be mine and him, right? Do one thing at a time. I've learned this in the hard way. I used to run because I am a multi-unit manager, right? So I multitask, right? But I realized I can accomplish more when if I do one thing at a time. And being a manager, leader, I learned how to delegate. Delegate something that I don't need to do it myself, right? Very simple task, I delegate it, but I really focus more on, like right now, recruiting. That's what I'm good at. And training, that's what I'm good at. So, but the training materials, I delegate it to my assistant. I delegate it to my assistant. Why do I have to do printing? That's a waste of time, right? Okay, these are the things that also that gets me going. Never think of negative things. Don't entertain, guys. No matter how they nail you down, they put you down, if you entertain that, what will happen? You are just gonna be ruining your day. The man without shoes, let me show you. Look at this. If you start complaining and whining, take a look at this guy. Right? He has no feet, but he's competing. And if you feel tired and lazy, this particular man is selling, even though there's only one leg. So if you think about it, we are complete. All you have to do is just be positive. You will be more competitive. Here's another one that I would like to tell you. This is my best practice that I put it in place all the time. I do not compete with anyone else. If you compete with anyone else, you start being jealous, envious, chit-chat, chismes, right? But if you just focus on yourself, you can adjust. Oh, I missed this, but I'm still competing with myself. I don't look at James Hartman the Great, right? I don't look at Odette's big organization in Hawaii. I don't. I compete with myself and grew from there. Three ways to fail at everything in life. Complain about everything. Blame others for your problems. Never be grateful, right? Every single day in the morning, I'm alive. Thank you so much. I just would like to share this with you guys. I just had a surgery 2 weeks ago in the surgery room. First time, I thought it was just in a movie. They knocked me down. Anesthesia, general anesthesia. You know what happened during that was lying? Because I heard when you get knocked down like that, you won't think anything. You're sleeping. I had a dream. I saw myself from kid to graduate to become a business owner like right now. And I knew if that happened, you're dead. You're dead. So I was like, shoot, I'm out of my body, right? But thank God I came back. And you know what? The first thing I saw on the poster in the hospital, Kobe Bryant, it says, the big problem of human being, they thought there's still more time. There's still more time. There's no more time. Every time you think about things, you gotta hustle, do it right now, because if it's too late and you still didn't do your mission, you will regret it. That's what happened to him. He did everything, but he's too young to die, right? So be thankful, great, give values to others, practice golden rule, pay forward. What is pay forward? I had the same scenario right now, like maybe three weeks ago. We were in the Starbucks drive-thru, right? My wife and I are starting to really irritated because the car in front of us is getting longer, it's getting slower. It took them 5 minutes. Remember, in the drive-thru, it's only 60 seconds, 1 minute, right? So it's like we're almost gonna honk, but after 5 minutes, he left, right? So when we're about to get our order, I said, how much is it? Oh, it's already paid for. Huh? The guy in front of you paid for you. Wow. I felt negative saying, get out of our way, we're about to leave. And he paid for our own Starbucks coffee, only two. So we look at it ourselves, and my wife said, let's find out how much is this guy at the back. So we pay it with a small one. I said, if you want to pay it forward, do it wholeheartedly. So we pay the same way. So there is a grace in your attitude when you have gratitude. No matter how bad is your day, when you say, thank God I'm alive, I'm telling you, it will change your day. Okay? You can beat someone who never. We spell quit, N-E-B-E-R. Whatever your mind can conceive and believe it can achieve, right? So, ladies and gentlemen, that's why Make It Happen actually was born. And this is our plug. I don't know if it's not working. It's not working. So we are now a so-called Make It Happen Eagles, because we make things happen because of my mentality. Okay, let me see. All right, this is some of the mission and vision that I created within myself. Every individual has the opportunity to excel or her potential to do more. I believe that. Our vision is to create more leaders in this company that will get things done. And I call it the rise of the ordinary, right? And here is my in summary. If you think in terms of a year, plant a seed. in terms of 10 years, plant the trees. But guess what? If you want to live longer, in terms of 100 years, teach and grow people. I will end up this presentation with a video, because I believe that no matter what you do, if no one is following you as a leader, you are not a leader. So ladies and gentlemen, let me show you, Marla, a video that we created. It's a 2-minute video that I would like you to take a look. You ready for that?
Yes, we are.
All right. Marla, are we ready? There you go. Watch it, how we started the Make It Happen in Banker's Life. Share the sound, please. Last part that I would like to show you, and I'm so proud to tell you, before I became a USM, we grew our group to 314 agents total and still growing. And I'm telling you, this year, we're going to kick some offices. Thank you, Mr. Kadivian. Do you have any question for me, any comment, and other leaders?
Fantastic job. Fantastic job.
Thank you
very
so
much. To the point, and something that everybody can relate to. What I relate to, what you're saying, is hard work. What time do you usually start your work at Bankers?
Mr. Kalibian, you want my honest or you want... No, I am a late type of manager or agent. I start around 9 o'clock because I have to take my youngest kid to school.
Right.
So I really walk like around 7 and then take her to 8 o'clock. But I work late. You know that. 1 o'clock,
right.
3 o'clock in the morning, I'm still working. So that's my I think, I don't know if it's my weakness, but I love to work like when I'm still alive, like awake at late night. Yes.
All right. Well, I mean, when you see people that don't make it with Bankers, with all the matching bonuses and quarterly bonuses and incentives that come out so many times a month, if they don't make it, it's only because they really haven't looked around to see people that are successful. What do they do? And what they do is work hard. I wish I could tell you that after 30 years of being in this business, I still work hard. I still work long hours. And he does too. And anyone that is successful, like Farshad, works many, many hours. This is how things are set up. But then you make six-figure income instead of 40,000 or 50,000, or thinking that somewhere else the grass is greener. So let's see if there are any questions that Domingo can answer.
Yes. This is your time, guys.
Any questions?
This is not a question, Domingo.
Hey, Ms. Odette, how are you?
Yeah, well, sorry, I'm here in Hawaii right now. And...
Yeah, you don't look sorry, Odette. You don't look sorry.
We had fun. And so, Domingo, you know, you are a very, what do you call this? Somebody who can really depend on during our early stage in Parker's life, you know, how we work really hard and open the door for mostly Filipinos that we brought in here. And you trained us so well that we were able to come up and reach our goals. Even I was not with you, I really appreciate until I learned. So of course, with the help of Mr. Kadivian and of Farshad, Mr. Farshad, we were able to make things happen, as you have said, that we are really growing. And I really appreciate your help, and I also appreciate the help that you have been offering to my team. And I know that you will make more in bankers, and you will be more aggressive in getting more people. And I hope that we will never separate. We'll be together, even if we are in separate ways. I know that we help each other. So thank you so much. I've learned a lot from you, and now here we are. We are here. I'm here right now, enjoying the breeze of Hawaii Island, and and I'm seeing one of our agents, and I can see most of the Hawaiian team are smiling, and I hope that, guys, we will stick together to the end. Thanks, Domingo. Thank you, Mr.
My pleasure. I think that's one thing that I would like to encourage all the leaders. Sometimes we are very territorial, right? But when you become a leader, you share everything. Mr. Kadibian hate me when I did that, because when I first came in, because I used to do training, anyone, even not in my team. I used to work with Pasadena agents when I was still brand new. And he said, why you have to train your people first? Said, yes, but they need help, so I help. I didn't even know that there is some in your organization you have to do. But right now, I think it works. All you have to do is open your arms. You have the knowledge, share it. How you grow the company depends on how the leaders will actually help those people or agent that needs help, right? So thank you. Mr. Kadibian, go ahead.
Well, anybody else has any question?